topic of discussion is about types of psychology. As you all know, there are different branches and specializations of psychology that have emerged in this 21st century. Today, I'll be taking you through some of them. One of the most important and most commonly known fields is clinical psychology. Clinical psychology is nothing but the psychology which helps you diagnose and treat different mental health disorders in a better way. Rather than prescription of drugs, clinical psychologist makes use of therapy to treat them. The next, which is very close to clinical psychology, is neuropsychology, or these days also called as biopsychology. These are the psychologists which are interested in the anatomy of brain and nervous system and exactly how it affects the cognitive abilities and our behavior. For example, if there is any injury to the brain, it can have profound effects on how we think and behave. Neuropsychologist or biopsychologist will be the main people who would be dealing with the same. The next area of psychology that we would be focusing on is counseling psychology. Counseling psychology is nothing but talking therapy. What is talking therapy? It helps clients deal with personal and interpersonal problems which they face in their daily life. Anything and everything with respect to that creates an obstruction or a delay in your daily functioning can have a major impact on your mental health issues, and counseling psychologists can be the right people to guide you and help you improve these conditions. With respect to the next area of psychology can be, you can take a guess. If you are a big fan of crime televisions or series on Netflix, yes, you guessed it right. I'm talking about forensic psychology. Forensic psychology is yet another field where you might have heard that these psychologists focus on working with conjunction with the justice system and understanding how does a criminal is motivated to do any kind of criminal offense. They interview the criminals and understand what were the motives behind their criminal offense and how much of a threat they can pose to the society. Coming on to our next branch is the area of sports psychology. Sports psychology would deal with a lot of factors that can affect an athlete's performance, including cognitive, emotional, motivational, physiological, or psychological factors. The other areas of psychology can be social psychology. So social psychology is nothing but understanding people's behavior in front of different environments. Okay, how do you change your behavior when you are with a certain group of people? And how does it change when you are with your family? Social psychologists are the people who would understand why that change happens and what shifts during that particular moment. Relating to that, there are different branches of social psychology that can be taken up as specialization. Somewhat like developmental psychology, educational psychology, or consumer psychology. Consumer psychology just basically means why do you make certain purchases instead of choosing something else? For example, consumer psychologists can be people who can actually understand the motive behind why did you make a certain purchase. For example, why did you choose Coca-Cola over a Pepsi is something that they would want to understand, and they would work on strategies to promote their product in a better fashion. The other area of psychology can be educational psychology, where educational psychologists will help you understand and assess the different educational problems, different difficulties that children might face in understanding different concepts. They can also be the people who can work with the special children, known as special educators. The other area of psychology can be occupational psychology, or sometimes also called as industrial or organizational psychology. This psychology branch deals with how to help out an employee in the work setting. So basically anything and everything that helps a worker in the organization to maintain a better mental health, a better work-life balance, and have a good productivity level. and what are the different factors that can affect their performance. So all of these are different domains of psychology that I wanted to highlight. If at all you have any queries, please feel free to get in touch. Please understand that at the bachelor's level, you would be exposed to all these different kinds of psychology, and make sure you take up different internships and certifications to understand the same. You can always choose your specialization domains at master's and PhD levels. Thank you so much. If at all there is anything I can help you with, please feel free to mail us at hello@therateminder.com. Thank you.